another record set. And alongside me this afternoon is Mac McCarroll. And Mac, what do you think? The odds of seeing another record fall this afternoon?
I don't know. It's going to be very tough. I'll tell you what, though. I've been working out a little plan here, Steve, and I think it's a Boris Yeltsin thing. That means you need three keys, right, to launch the big one. Number one, they got to get their rhythm early. Number two, and this is very important, score points.
But that would seem key.
It sounds silly, but that means no missed layups. And if they should get a free throw, they got to make them, because that's points when the clock's not running. And then the third key is a little cooperation from Devry. And I think we're going to get it. They had a good time last year, scored 120-something themselves.
That's setting a school record themselves.
Also, that's an electronics play. They could get up and rewire that scoreboard.
They may have
we
to
only go to 199, as you so aptly pointed out in your story this week.
Well, I think the Devry is excited about this ball game, even though they probably realize they're a little bit outmanned, and it's one of the few games actually that Troy will actually outsize their opponent.
That's right. They've played a lot of teams that are a lot bigger than them this year, and this Devry team is a young team. They've lost everybody except one player from the team that came here last year, so they are going to be in over their heads, but. Like I said, they had a lot of fun last year during this game. In fact, the leading scorer in that game was a fellow by the name of Stubbs, who was from Devry in that Troy State win. He was the high scorer with 57 points.
That's right. He took no fewer than 38 three-point shots in that game. And let's talk a little bit about getting to that mythical 200. It's not really probable that can happen, but this team, Troy State, really believes it's possible.
Well, and that's part of it. The attitude that the players have, you know, you talked to them during practice a couple days ago, and most of them thought that if they got hot and they got streaky, that wouldn't be a problem.
Yeah, in fact, Coach Maestri ran a little drill with them, didn't he?
Shooting drill, right? He, Coach Maestri thinks that they got to hit 50 threes a half to do it.
Not in a half, then for a half?
Yeah, and so he gave him a little shooting drill, and he said, see how many you can make in 10 minutes. See if you can make 50 threes in 10 minutes. They made 82 in 5 minutes. Called off the drill. That was the end of it.
Well, let's see if we can set the starting lineup for this ball game this afternoon for Troy State. Troy State's going to start their usual starting five in this ball game. They're going to go with Jack Smith, the forward, who coincidentally is the Sports Illustrated Small College Player of the Week this week.
That's right. It's quite an honor for Jack.
He's a 6'3 senior from Athens. He averages 19.5 per outing. Andy Davis will get the starting point guard again. He's a senior from Greenville. He averages 9.6. Number 30 is Terry McCord. I guess you could call him the center. He's 6'5. He's a junior from Anniston. He's the leading scorer on the ball club at 19.9 a game. Number 14, Tommy Davis, a guard, a 6'1 junior from Atala. He chips 16.1 an outing. And DeAndre Evans, a forward, 6'5 sophomore from Montgomery, 7.1 a game. DeAndre was the player who made the shot to break the record last
week. He had 28 points in that game.
He told me before the ball game he wants to be the guy who breaks his own name out of the record book today.
And I'd like to see him get a shot at it.
Troy State ball club actually, last year, they're averaging 3 points more per outing this year.
Right about 109 points a game, I think.
Dan Devry, let's set Devry's lineup for you now. At guard, number 10 will be Tim Young, a 6'1 freshman, and you'll listen to the number of freshmen that they start on this ball club. He's from Jacksonville, Florida. Number 12, Chad Heeling, a guard, a 6'5 freshman from Lexington, Kentucky. And at center is Dartez Daniel, a 6'9 junior from Sandersville, Georgia. And number 30 is Clayton Jones, a 6'1 guard, the only sophomore starting from Vidalia, Georgia. He was also a veteran of the team that played here last year, so he's been through this war before. Number 40 is Sean Kyler, a guard, a 6'1 freshman from Bronx, New York.
We got to be honest with folks. We didn't know anything about any of these guys except when we saw them warming up. So.
As a matter of fact, when we got their roster initially, they had 12 players listed, but they only showed up with 7 guys. You got to talk a little bit about what kind of shape these guys are going to have to be in to keep up with this style of play for 40 minutes.
They're going to have to run.
Okay, I think we're getting ready for the starting lineup here in just a moment. Coach Mason's huddling with his players on the sideline, and course, there's really not many plans to go over, and there's no secrets about what Troy State's going to do in this game.
Yep. You got to come out firing and hitting early. That's going to be the key.
All right, let's pause for just a second for the national anthem.
Mason Jackson of Troy.
Devry players are coming over to congratulate
them. Absolutely. That was a rousing national anthem, to say the least.
And she always gets this place torqued up.
I tell you what, that's
look
something
at Andy.
Else.
Have you ever seen Andy Davis when he wasn't smiling? That guy's got a smile in his sleep.
All the time. Well, Coach Maestri is sending his baklava out on the floor, and there's Devry doing the obligatory handshakes before the game, and hopefully this one will stay friendly throughout.
Oh, I think it will. I think this is going to be a lot of fun. The crowd is still drifting in here. Looks like we'll get this place filled up before the end of the day.
Devry has inserted Michael Ramsey in the starting lineup, and he's going to jump it up against Andy Davis, and Troy controls the tap, and and already we've got a three up off the back iron. Troy wastes no time. Andrew Evans for three. Good. And Devry's got a rebound. Stolen by Evans. He'll bring the ball up and they'll force it every chance they get. He'll stop for two. No good. Rebound Devry. And there, it looks like Devry's going to come out running and gunning. And there's a steal by Terry McCord.
Terry McCord.
Mac, it doesn't look like Devry is showing any signs whatsoever of wanting to slow this thing down so far.
They're both up and down.
Absolutely.
It's the first time they've had an offensive chance.
And there's a turnover. Michael Ramsey lost the handle on the end line, and here comes Troy back the other way. And I don't know, man, about...
things are a little tight right now.
Yeah, keeping up this action. They wanted to come out and score a lot of points early, and they may be pressing right now. And there's two for Andy Davis. A nice assist right there from Andrew Evans.
Troy State, the man-to-man full court.
And
ref getting a little assistance from one of the fans over there who's looking pretty nasty.
Yeah, the refs, we haven't mentioned their names. Let's do that. Paul Andrzejewski, Mike Murphy, and Bill Galden have the unenviable task of running up and down the floor during this game. And I tell you, Devry is just looking to break the press by throwing the long pass. Helig with the miss, his own follow no good. And the ball's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to remain the Hoyas ball.
How much patience the crowd has with their already couple boo birds. Apparently they expect to see 25 or 30 up there by now.
And there's another steal by Troy.
Look out here.
And up ahead to Jack Smith, and he'll throw it down. Tomahawk, Jack Smith.
It's a good sign to see they're making their dunks
and
tonight.
And there's another steal by Troy. Tommy Davis will fire it up from three, no good. Rebound control by Jack Smith. He'll turn around, put it back up. No good. Rebound Andy Davis. He leads the team in rebound. He'll fire it back out to Tommy Davis. He'll shoot three. No good. Again, Andy Davis with the rebound. And he'll go to Terry McCord from way out. And that's good. comes to Fry, I tell you what, they are throwing long every time. There's McCord again for three. No good off the front iron. And I tell you what, DeVry is looking to get it up every time. An incomplete pass, I guess you could say. And there's Michael Ramsey again having trouble, and it's going to go up on Troy.
I'll tell you, the way DeVry is outlining this, we might want to see if we can get some defensive backs from Coach Blakeney, because they're
Rodney
firing the bombs.
Wheeler in
yeah,
here
really. Get a couple
of
pickoffs.
Of these passes. I tell you what. People who stayed home to watch the NFL playoffs won't see this many bombs in that game. Not a bad crowd, really, for a Sunday afternoon.
No, it's a nice little crowd, and they'll get heated up here as soon as we hit a couple more of those threes.
7-0, Troy leads it with 17:50 to go in the first. And DeVry will turn it over. And DeAndre Evans will inbound it and get the Troy offense rolling. Jack Smith for three.
There it is.
That's 10 points. And Mac, it doesn't take a mathematician to figure out that if Troy could reach the 200-point mark, they'd have to get 5 points per minute.
5 points per minute. They're not doing that right now, but I'll tell you, that last shot was the first one that Jack Smith took where he really looked.
Tommy Davis lays it in. 12-0. DeVry yet to crack the scoreboard, and they just threw that ball away. If there wasn't a wall there, that ball would have rolled all the way out to 231.
Oh, Michael from photography better keep his eye open. He's waving to the crowd, I'm okay.
And Tommy missed Davis his head. For three, no good. Rebound, Andy Davis. That's about three for him on the day. Here's Jack Smith again. That's for three.
Smith.
Troy pressing hard every time now. They've got four guys in the backcourt every time DeVry brings it up, and now for
three.
D'Artes Daniel, the 6'9 center from Sandersville, gets him on the board first. There's Terry McCord from three. No good air ball. And now here comes DeVry the other way, 15-3. Troy leads it. And he'll take it all the way to the hole.
Nice move.
That was an excellent move. Clayton Jones was in this war last year. And now here's a steal by DeVry. Chad Healy will stop and pop from three. No good. And they've got a rebound. And puts it back up and good. D'Artes Daniel again. Now he's got 5 points. And there's a long bomb to Jack Smith. He'll get it back outside. Tommy Davis will fire it up. Off the front of the rim. No good. Here comes DeVry. 3-0. And the prettiest dunk you're gonna see, but they don't give style points, so still counts as 215-9. Troy leads it. And here's Andy Davis down. So he'll get it back out. And here's Terry McCord will pop it up from three. No good. So the Trojans cold with their three-point shooting early on. And here's D'Artes Daniel again for three.
Block
and partially
Andy.
Blocked by Andy Davis. And here they get it back up. Tommy Davis with a nice pass into Jack Smith with another jam. Jack Smith. His second big jam of the game. And there's a block by Terry McCord. He blocked it, but Jack Smith controls it. Looked like he was going to block that into the first roll in here. And McCord, we've got a foul. The first foul with almost 5 minutes gone. That's the first foul in the ball game. And they're going to call it on Clayton Jones. 6'1", sophomore guard, the veteran leader of this ball club from Vidalia, Georgia. Just a sophomore, four freshmen right now on the floor. For DeVry. And there's the oop! Terry McCord can't do it. D'Artes Daniel with the rebound, and he'll bring it up himself. He's gonna go coast to coast. He lays it up and in. D'Artes Daniel. And here's Troy getting a little sloppy, trying to outlet the ball quickly. And they'll turn it over.
Tell you what, McCord really got up on that block.
Right now, Jack Smith has 10 points already for the Trojans as they lead it 17-11. 15 minutes to go. Here's Chad Healy driving in. Oh, and he has that completely rejected by DeAndre Evans. And here's Jack Smith. Could be the third jam of the day. And he's showtime that one, to say the least.
Nice over the head, behind the back pass.
Nice. They should give style points. And there's a nice layup. No, it comes up short. Chad
good
Healy
move.
Controls for DeVry. He'll take it right back up with a nice sweeping hook. No good. Rebound DeVry up again. D'Artes Daniel. Daniel's got six
Daniel
now.
Trojans getting ready to shuttle in Gresham, Simpson, and who
Tim
else?
Faison.
Tim Faison's down there.
There's Terry McCord again for three. That's good. Nice.
Terry
42-13. Troy leads it. There's DeVry stopping. No good.
Big three there.
Andy Davis with the rebound. He's got a bucket full so far. And there's DeAndre Evans.
Oh, man. Quickness by Evans displayed there. And he comes back and makes a nice defensive play.
We've got an offensive foul there on Sean Kyler. He tried to take it in, 1-on-3, and they called him for the
freshman,
offensive
foul. Fred Bryant is over there. I'll tell you what, they're going to need a harness for him before the end of the game. But he sees Smith and those guys dunk. You know, he missed like 5 dunks the other night, and he wants to make amends, so he's ready to get in there.
He's got a lot of examples to learn. Brian Simpson is short on a three-pointer, and it's stolen by Gresham. Now, you want to see somebody who'll shoot a three-pointer from way out. That's Chris Gresham. There's Tim Faison, the Troy native, up short again. And it goes out of bounds.
USA Today reported Friday that they discovered 2 new planets. And Gresham is shot from one of those planets.
Yeah, he shot a couple balls on that road trip before he even got off the bus, I think. Let's talk a little bit about that road trip while we have a half a second.
Get people caught up on that Division I swing that we made. Georgia Southern, Auburn, and Wyoming. Gave Georgia Southern a real good game. We lost by 8. Got down real early. First 10 minutes, Auburn was up by about 24, but played him even for the rest of that game.
Faison with the steal after a Gresham miss. There's Faison outlaying to Brian Simpson, and he can knock those down.
And then out to the Rangers of Wyoming, pulled within 8 of Wyoming. Picked to win the WAC this year in Division I. They end up winning that game. Wyoming ended up winning the game by 16.
There's Fred Bryant, no good. Rebound Simpson, and a nice dish to Paul Bryant.
Excellent play by Simpson.
29-15. 13 minutes to go, another Troy steal. And they finally control. And here's Brian Simpson, and that's going up, and it's going off the back of the iron. Fred Bryant with the rebound, he'll give it back to him, he'll put it up again. No good this time. Gresham tries to control, can't do it, and it's out of bounds. Off on DeVry. Jack Smith leads the Trojans with scoring so far. He's got 12 points. Tommy Davis has kicked in 5, and Brian Simpson's got 3, and he'll launch another one here, and that's off. Tim Faison controls. He'll put it up from 3. No good again. And D'Artes Daniels will fire it up court. Eugene Quarles will put it up. No good. Gresham with the
intimidates.
Rebound. Yeah. Gresham's a force on the other end. Fred Bryant.
Nice, Fred. I'll tell you what, Fred Bryant is going to really contribute here at Troy State. He has turned out to be a real diamond in the rough. He is so athletic.
Gresham with the rebound, and he just brings it right up court. Brian Simpson again will go up from 3. That's good. Give Simpson enough opportunity, and he's going to knock 3 of them down.
I think
he's got 6 points now.
As you know, anybody on this team will put up a 3, but I think when it comes to the pure shooting threes, it's Jack Davis and Simpson, no doubt.
Chad Heiling.
Simpson has already attempted 6 three-point shots so far. He leads his team in three-pointers made, by the way. Chris Gresham leads the ball club in percentage-wise, but Simpson has made the most of him. D'Artes Daniel with the leaner won't go, and the foul out. And it goes back up. We'll see. They give the basket to Chad Heiling. There's Tim Faison. He'll stop from 3. Off the further end, no good. Heiling with the rebound. And DeVry having a little trouble with their break. But I tell you what. You know, we said at the outset, if this was going to be a really high-scoring game and Troy had a shot to get to the record or even to that mythical 200, that DeVry was going to have to cooperate. That was one of your 3 keys. Well, guess what? They're cooperating.
Full cooperation on the part of DeVry.
It's 34-17. We're a little bit off the pace that we need to be on to break the record. But I tell you what, they may break a record for steals right here in the first half. There's Tim Faison. And Fred Bryant! Yeah, Bryant did not miss that one. And D'Artes Daniel is going to have to put his arm with ice his arm down after the game.
I told you, Fred Bryant was licking his chops when he saw this thing get going on here.
Control, and it's stolen by DeVry. And here's Heilig again. And he'll take it right to the hoop, and that's an offensive foul as Chris Gresham stayed in there and took the charge. And it'll go back the other way. 36-19, 11:25 to go.
Comes on number 12, Chad Heiling. That's his first.
And we've played almost
10,
almost 9 minutes now, and there's yet to be a foul called on the Trojans. And here's Tim Faison's going to stop. He looked like he wanted to pop, and he'll just drive through and dish now to Bryant. But he loses a handle, but gets it back.
lays it up and
in. By Fred. Brian.
Fred's always ready to jam.
He wanted to jam.
He wanted to jam that time, but he did misjudge his distance. He's still talking about the walk they called on him in the Auburn game, where he jammed one. He still plays
it again.
I'll tell you, he is so smooth.
He's now got three. Yeah, he's got the prettiest release on the Trojan basketball team.
Well, they got 55 seconds to score 9 points, and they're right on the pace.
And I tell you what, you look over here at the Trojan bench, and assistant coach David Felix and Don Maestri are working those squeeze bottles so hard. They're as excited as their ball players right now. They want to see the points go up. There's into Paul Bryant. He'll drive it nicely. That's good. Paul is not used to being the tallest guy in the paint.
On the paint, he's usually got people looking down on
him. There's DeVry laying it up and in with an easy two there. That was
this
Eugene
is going
Paul.
Up. Hit that.
Again.
No good. Nice. Oh, excellent foul by Bryant.
Bear. They call him Bear Bryant. He's got 6 points. Fires it up to DeVry.
Nice.
That's good.
2 points.
45-23. Since he'll get the ball back to Faison. They're taking it now into Bryant again. He'll drive in. Has it picked off. And here's Helig. He'll try to throw it down, and he does. Chad Helig.
I tell you what, you can't, for an afternoon entertainment, I mean, both these teams, you can't get, it doesn't get better than this. Everybody's
there's
jamming.
For three. Rebound Simpson. He'll turn around and put it up. And he'll make it.
And basket.
The rare 2-point attempt for Brian Simpson. And there's a chance
again
from DeVry. Pass a little bit long. Helig with the rebound. Mass substitutions coming for the Trojans. Fred Bryan with the. And there's Simpson again for three, and it's good.
Maestri coaching this like a hockey game. He's got another line coming.
Simpson now with 13. Here's Chad Helig for three. Short, and there's the putback. It's good.
Rebound.
By number 40, Sean Kyler. Paul Bryan with the jam as he hangs on the rim to emphasize the point. Look out, it's now 52-27. 9:13 to go, and we've got a foul. And I believe they're gonna call it on Bryan Simpson, the first foul on the Trojans. And we finally, mercifully, have a stoppage in play for just a moment.
At least for the officials' sake.
We're gonna need those squeeze bottles here in a minute.
I'll tell you what.
And the Trojans, even though they're playing up this up-paced tempo, they've only turned it over three times, which is a. And there's Chad Helig popping in from about 5 feet. And Steve Hunt's now in the ball game for the Trojans. He'll get the ball back and get it out to Simpson. And another shot from three, no good, and the follow by Andrea Evans.
Nice foul. Jack Smith coming back in.
All right, the Trojans have got Simpson, Andy Davis, Steve Hunt, Andrea Evans, and Terry McCord on the floor.
Steve Hunt coming from behind and trying to pick his pocket there.
Jack Smith.
Steve Hunt and Bryan Simpson, both JUCO transfers from Kentucky, and they can really, both of them can fill it up from three, as Simpson has already shown that power.
Simpson's got the ice bucket on both his arms now.
Yeah.
He's soaking him down.
D'Artes Daniel, the tallest member of the team, and he looks like the best ball handler for DeVry. There's a 3-point bucket for Eugene Quarles.
3 points.
Matching up against Jack Davis.
And there's Terry McCord from NBA
That's a pro three right there.
57-32. Another steal by Troy by McCord. Gets it to D'Andre Evans for three.
They're
going to call it three. It's south. 60-32. And it's stolen again by Troy. Andy Davis controls it. Now he's got a little trouble in the backcourt, but he breaks through the press. And he brings it up, and the dish to McCord, who gives it back to Davis, over his head to Evans, a shot up short, no good, rebound Jack Smith. Smith will fire it up from three, that's good, Jack Smith.
Popcorn
steal by Troy.
Full tilt
Andy
now.
Davis is having a blast. Now he gets it to Evans, who thought about jamming it, but he turns it over for the finger roll, that's good. Jack Smith has 15. His average is 19.5 per ball game. I think he might get that tonight. And there's a steal by Smith. He'll stop from three. Oh, no good. Steve Hunt with the rebound. He doesn't want anything inside that arc. He takes it back outside. No good. Jack Smith
rebound.
With the foul.
I'll tell you what, Jack looked as if he knew that was coming to him.
I tell you what, the Trojans have just a ton of offensive rebounds so far. And DeVry takes it in. No good. D'Artes Daniel tries to get the rebound, but Terry McCourt jumps in front of him. He'll get the ball to Steve Hunt, who stops from guess where behind the arc. Fires it up. It's good. 7 minutes to go. Troy State has 70 points. 70 to 32. And Chad Helig again will turn around. He's got a nice little touch from in there. He's got the bulk of DeVry's points. He's got about 10 now, I think, unofficially. And there's Jack Smith with the move with a Terry McCourt. Oh, my goodness. I tell you what, this is showtime. Jack Smith again from three, no good. But the foul is good from Andrew Evans. I tell you what, this is some kind of showing we're seeing here by the Trojans. And DeVry has got smiles all over their faces. Helig again from three.
Helig's going to keep smiling. He's pouring in the points.
Helig is going to boost his average up. There's Jack Smith. He gives it up to Terry McCourt for three. That's good.
Jack didn't want to be selfish. He dished it off to McCourt.
77 to 37. Trojans lead it by 30 to Andrew Evans for three. That's good. 80 to 37. I tell you what, we're definitely going to see something special here.
They are cooking with gas right now. Jack with a little head fake, but he won't have to do
it. Laying it in for the pride. And Coach Maestri. Oh, and then Troy turns it over for the fourth time this afternoon. Coach Maestri has got a grin on his face right now.
Look at Felix.
Coach Felix,
he's going to suck that plastic star right down his throat.
And we've got another four substitutions now.
And Pat Evans, who's an assistant coach on the team this year, he played in that game last year against DeVry. He looks like he wants to just get out there and fire it up right now.
Yeah, he was one of the leading scorers for Troy last year, and he looks like he wishes he had another year of eligibility.
Look out for
Terry McCourt, lays it in.
You know, Tommy Joe Eagles from Auburn in a post-game interview after we went out and played Auburn said that McCourt was probably going to be one of the best forwards that his team played against this year, so that's how high they were on him.
There's Steve Hunt for three. No good, short. It's short. Tommy Davis tries for the rebound. Gresham's there, though. It's put back, it's good. It's now 84 to 39, folks. It's 84 to 39 with 5:24 to go in the first half. Just Jack Smith throws down about his fifth dunk of the game. Steve Hunt with a pick off to Tommy Davis. Easy lay in, no good. Rebound, Jack Smith will pick it up, and he goes, guess where, outside the arc. He turns around, fires, no good. Oh, a foul by Gresham is no good. Rebound, McCourt, he shoots from three. This Troy State team wants 200, there's no doubt about that.
Gresham.
There's Gresham, hits the side of the board. No good, I tell you what, but threes are the order of the day, to say the least, as Eugene Quarles, check that, Sean Kyler lays it in. Tommy Davis for three, no, make it the oop.
Nice.
Into Terry McCourt, and controls it and plays it in nicely. Terry
McCourt.
You
need a towel for Fred Bryan over here, because he's drooling, getting ready to come back.
Terry McCourt is chalking up the points now. He's got 15, Jack Smith has 19. And there's number 10, Tim Young, trying to no avail three times. Can't do it, and here's Steve Hunt getting the ball up to Jack Smith. He'll lay it out for Tommy Davis for three. It's good.
It's good.
91 to 41. 50-point Troy lead. 4:20 to go in the first. And there's the attempt to move by DeVry. And I tell you what, they're having a good time. I don't care if they are losing by 50. Oh, it's a 360. Terry McCourt. He misses it. Troy controls the rebound. Tommy Davis.
Miss the whirly bird.
I tell you what. Folks, NFL football pales in comparison to this. There's
Fred Bryan just told Tim Faison he was going to try that shot. So I got to try that.
And mass substitutions waiting again. Jack Smith couldn't control the oop, and it goes out of bounds. Off of Tim Young for DeVry, and Troy State controls it. Here comes Paul Bryan, Tim Bryant, Tim Faison, and Brian Simpson checking in the game for Steve Hunt. Jack Smith to a standing O from this crowd. My goodness. And the cheerleaders have really, they've reached a euphoria now that they're going to have to be sedated. Brian Simpson has made a three-pointer, and I think the Troy State shot attempts are about 3-1, three-pointers to two-pointers. No one has been to the free-throw line in this ballgame. Chris Gresham now bringing the ball up court. It's 4-on-1, and he'll take it all the way and turn it over and jam it. Chris Gresham.
There's the bomb.
And here's D'Artes Daniel with an easy hoop the other way. Fred Bryan gave him some D, but Daniel laid it in, and here's Brian Simpson. You think he'll put it up? No! There's the alley-oop to Paul Bear Bryan, and he'll lay it in.
Excellent pass for Simpson.
Bryan, and this crowd is ecstatic. They love what they're understand they have reached the century mark. It's 100-45. We have 3 minutes to go in the first half.
I'll tell you what, those interviews.
And there's another oop to Gresham. No good off the back iron. Can't do it. Rebound, D'Artes Daniel.
Those interviews you did Friday, somebody said 210, and they may get to 210.
There's a missed jam by Sean Kyler.
That missed jam went into section F of the reserve section. They had to retrieve the ball. I don't know if they're allowed to keep those or not.
We are not even near the end of the first half, and Paul Bryan has 8 points, 5 points higher than his average, and they've all been very low percentage shots. And Paul Bryan has just given the high sign to this, the crowd. They're having a blast. Fred Bryan thought about it from three. He'll give it to Brian Simpson, who never thinks about it from three. He'll put it up. Rebound to Devry. And there's the easy. Nope. He misses the bunny.
Rebound.
Chris Gresham will bring it back the other way. The tallest guy on the floor bringing it up, gives it to Paul Bryan, who, guess what, jams it. And there's no such thing as just a vanilla jam for this team, and he almost threw that ball in the gondola.
That looked like Ray Guy kicking a punt in the Superdome, didn't it?
That's Michael Ramsey laying it in for Devry. Brian Simpson again for three, and I tell you what, it's now 105-47. And Devry throws it away.
Well, I put out my pregame notebook, and I wanted to say, and I'll read it to you right here. I said Simpson and Jack Smith will be the keys or the pure three shooters. And I'll tell you what, Simpson, in that Auburn game,
Simpson now has 21 points.
He came across half court in Auburn and made one dribble and pulled up and hit nothing but net. And their whole bench looked at each other and said, where did this guy come from?
And we have, folks, an NCAA record. The most points scored in a half, broken, and they broke their own record of 103 done last year. If they score 105 points, and folks, they're gonna have to get the white out in the record book after this one is over if we continue on anything near this pace.
I'll tell you what, there's still 2 minutes left.
There's 2 minutes left in the half, and we keep saying it. We don't want to belabor the point, folks, but it's 105-47. There have only been four fouls called in this ball game.
Tom Enzi's pen is smoking over there. I don't know how they're keeping up.
Tom Enzi and the rest of the sports information staff are going to have to go to the mainframe over at BibGrade to do the halftime stats.
They are. They're not going to be able to use that mimeograph machine anymore. That's going to be out.
No, they're going to have to. And I tell you what, there's going to have to be at least two appendixes to the halftime stats. And there may be a small novel published when the whole game stats come out.
I'll tell you what.
And Coach Maester is yelling out instructions to his team for the first time all afternoon. I can't imagine what that could be. I can't see any adjustments
that need to
be made.
I'll tell you what, if he starts coaching now, he might screw things up. He may want to just stay down on the bench and watch the show like everybody else is.
And Brian Simpson, he's going to lead the world in three-point attempts after this ball game. And we have a foul, a rare foul, and the whistle blows for once. And I tell you what, the resale value on that whistle is going to be pretty high because they hadn't blown it very often.
That's right. I think that probably, if he's got a receipt, he'd probably take it back.
So now, with 1:56 to go in the first half, with every basket the Trojans make, they break their own NCAA scoring record. And Tim Mason has just done it by three.
Just added three to the pot.
Point line. Paul Bryan with the rebound. And here's Troy's own Tim Faison shooting it up. No good. He gets his own rebound. He'll drive it in. No good. Gives it off to Fred Bryant, and he is fouled again.
They'll call the blue. One of the officials is commenting, don't call too many on the blue. Apparently they're a little thin today. They brought seven players to the game, and
well, they can't risk anybody fouling out, but I tell you, I don't think it's going to happen today. There's only been four fouls in the period. They call that one on D'Artes Daniel. That's his first. And there's Brian Simpson for three. It rattles and goes. Brian Simpson's got 24 points.
Coach Maestri told me before the game that in the second half of last year's game, they blew one foul the entire second half.
Brian
and that
Simpson
was on Troy, I think.
Brian Simpson has now attempted 15 three-point shots. No good. Gresham with the rebound. Fred Bryant's got it. Three on one. He'll take it the whole way. It's good.
Layup is good by Fred Bryant.
D'Artes Daniel with the leap and leaner. It's good. 113-49.
And there's Simpson giving up for one of the few times to Bryant, and he comes up short on the jam, but he lays it back. It's no good. The butt, and there's Paul Bryant. Fred Bryant just kind of had a look on his face like, that's not supposed to happen.
I'll tell you what, Fred, he takes some abuse from these other players during practice because he's a freshman. And he went in that 0 for 5 jam stretch the other day. They were really giving it to him in practice.
Yeah, watching the team film from the other night, it was basically an easy victory over Tuskegee, but I'm sure he got some good-natured ribbing from his teammates for those jams, and that's just going to add to it. But I tell you what, there's nothing but smiles on his teammates' faces right now as Devry gets a rare defensive rebound. They'll bring it up court, Eugene Quarles. He looks for anybody to give it up to. And we may actually see the shot clock get down to 36 seconds. We haven't seen that so far.
Chris Grisham.
We haven't said anything about the shot clocks because they haven't come into play at all.
They haven't.
Very seldom do 3 seconds go off the clock before Tim Faison fires up a three or any number of other Trojans.
Faison's got the hot touch now.
It's now 118-49, and Devry looking to crack the 50 mark, and they get it right there. That's Sean Kyler. He's got 4 points now for Bryant. There's Paul Bryant. Bryant now with 14 points. And
I'll tell you what, we got a three-man weave going down here with two guys.
It really is, and the Bryant players, they're a little bit tired right now, and you can't blame them. There's Fred Bryant from three. It's good. 123-53. A standing ovation for the record-setting Great State Trojans. They have shattered the record for most points in a half by 20, count them, 20 points.
Tell you what, the happiest faces in the gym right now are the officials because they are whacked out.
Well, I tell you what, this is really, you know, we thought it would be improbable, really, to see this kind of thing happen again, but not only is it probable, it looks like it's going to be more than possible. Last year, when they broke the record of 187 points, Troy had only 84 points in the first half. Folks, they've got 123 now.
I'll tell you what, that didn't look like they were going to be able to take a shot at it through the first 10 minutes, but then Simpson got hot. Jack Davis got hot for that 2 or 3 minute stretch, and they scored about 30 points in 2 or 3 minutes.
We'll talk about the halftime stats in just a minute, as soon as Tom Enzi can get back from the mainframe over at Bib Grade. All right, Mac. Well, we've got a few records, obviously, that are going to fall in this game. Troy State has already made 21 three-pointers in this ball game. The record for a game is 25. Field goals attempted in a game, three-point field goals attempted in a game, the record is 70. We've already attempted 52. Field goals attempted in a game, the record is 144. We've already attempted 96 of them.
I think all those records are going to go by the wayside today.
They're all going to go by the wayside. And I tell you what, I saw one of the best acts of sportsmanship you could possibly imagine it just a couple minutes ago. Coach Maystreet went over to the Devry coach, George Trawick, and talked to him and made sure that he understood the reason why Troy State was trying to score the points they were. And Coach Trawick just kind of laughed. And he's into this. He knows what Troy's trying to do, and he knows they're not trying to run the score.
Yeah, I know. I think he understands that. I think he knew that coming in after last year's game because it wasn't very much after the Devry game last year was over that all of a sudden people started toying with that idea of scoring 200 points in a game. And they knew when they came down here they were going to have their hands full. And it's like you say, trying to call off the dogs or whatever. I mean, every player on the Troy State bench is going to be in this game, has already been in the game and is contributing in the game. This is a very talented, deep team. And it gets to be one of those things where you say, what are you going to do, throw the ball out of bounds or shoot it over the basket? You can't do that.
Right, and it's also another thing that this is really the only offense that Troy State has. They don't run the set offense, per se. They don't have ties. This is their offense.
Yeah. They don't run that half-court offense, any of that post-up stuff at all. And this is the only way they know how to play. It's like taking a Greyhound and telling them to slow down. You can't do it. This team is bred to run.
And again, for Devry, this is some... Although, be it they're on the losing end, they're going to get some national exposure out of this. During last year's games, they were on ESPN. They're a small school. They don't get a lot of national exposure. In the long run, it's going to be good for their program to get this kind of exposure. And a lot of their players are going to probably have career highs before this thing is over.
My guess is a couple of them are going to have the best games of their careers. They're already well on their way to to having a good game. So.
Yeah, as you might imagine, the halftime stats are not ready yet from Tom Enzi, but
the way I understand it is they're cranking up the computer because they can't figure it all out.
Yeah. And we're just about to get ready for the second half of play. And we want to mention while we've got a chance, because when this game starts, we're not going to have a chance. Talk a little bit about the women's game on Saturday night.
Exactly. The women are now 10-1 after their 92-45 win over Mississippi University for women Saturday night. And this is something the fans ought to take note of. This is a very good women's basketball team. They've got a couple excellent new additions from the junior college ranks, Athena Armour and Odessa Wallace, and then all the players who are back from last year. Jennifer Edgar, Nellie Fields, LaDonna Hardy are all back, and this team is ranked right now, I believe.
18th.
Division II. So,
they play an exciting brand of basketball, I tell you what.
They've got a tough game coming up this week. I think UNA is coming into town, so we'll try to dig up the schedule and let people know this week when the Lady Trojans are going to be playing.
And we're underway in the second half, and the smiles have come back to the DeVry faces, and they've got a basket already. 123-55. Jack Smith starts the second half just like he started the first half. Cortez Daniel with the lay-in on the other end.
Daniel.
I'm waiting for Cortez to slam one. He wasn't set up for that one, but I think he's got one coming.
There's Tommy Davis for three, no good, air ball. And here comes the try the other way, Andy Davis. Andy Davis has just got a huge smile on his face. Jack Smith for three, no good. And another steal by Troy. There's Tommy Davis for three. Good.
3 points, Tommy Davis.
It's now 128-57. Another steal by Troy. We've said that at least 40 times tonight. There's Jack Smith for three. Good.
3 points.
131, and the magic number now.
Look out.
As the DeVry player throws the ball about three rows up.
Aaron pass there.
Spectator was thinking they got to keep that, but I don't think so. They'll throw it back. And the referee checking the ball to make sure it isn't damaged. Andrea Evans with the oop to Terry McCord.
Andrea Evans with the assist.
And their finger roll comes up short.
Rebound.
Andy Davis coming back the other way. Tommy Davis will stop from three. Good.
3 points.
135-57.
Hey, Tommy was one of those interviewees who predicted 210, 220 maybe.
Yes.
210, 220, whatever it takes.
And I tell you, at the time, we kind of looked at each other and smirked like these people were crazy, but I tell you what.
Well, once they did, when they did that shooting drill, though, the smirks turned to looks of surprise and belief, really. They poured in the threes, and 82 threes in 5 minutes. And everybody was shooting, and it was one shot
Daniel
at a time.
D'Artes Daniel's got to be getting near his career high. D'Artes Daniel's got, oh my goodness, Terry McCord. D'Artes Daniel having a very good game. We might see a backcourt. Is that the call? Yep, turns it over. And at the end of the first half, it looked like DeVry wasn't having that good a time. As you might have
heard. Whoever players got those pumps on, now they were ready to pump it up.
Yeah, you got to give them a lot of credit. D'Artes Daniel again.
Daniel.
143-63. The magic number, folks, is 187. That's Dandrea Evans for three again.
Dandrea Evans.
As another land for DeVry.
Sean Tyler.
187, the magic number. That's the NCAA record, Troy's own record for most points in a game. It appears that that's going to fall and fall early in the second half. Andrea Evans has it blocked by the rim. Jack Smith with a follow, no good. And DeVry with the rebound. And throws out of bounds. 146-65, 17:02. It's going to be hard, Mac, to keep up with the kind of records that may end up falling in this game.
Looks like the band fell asleep up there.
Yeah. There's Terry McCord for three.
Terry McCord.
Now the media folks are starting to shuffle around.
Yeah, I tell you what.
Andy Davis.
And we've just broken a record for most threes attempted in a game.
That's
our statistician Tony Harris has told us, but that is unofficial. Jack Smith officially misses the lay-in.
Tony's on his fourth pencil.
Tommy Davis, oh, with the jab.
Oh, he can get up for a little guy, can he?
He's 6'1". Look
out.
Jack Smith with the assist.
Chad Helig with the pull-up jumper off the glass. Nice kiss shot.
That was a nice little bank shot.
And here comes the, second line.
The Bryant line is coming in. They're talking over the game plan right below us.
Offensive rebound after offensive rebound. Tommy Davis misses, and finally Devry comes up with it. Clayton Jones. Clayton Jones was here last year and took part in this. He goes down, hits it off the back iron, gets his own rebound, pump fake up, and no good. Troy controls Andy Davis, and he does a little behind the back and he splits a knee. High steps it down the court. He's taking it all the way. Now he dishes it out to McCord, who shoots the three. Good. Andy Davis looked like Deion Sanders. Coming down the court there, high stepping. Let's try to talk about how many points the Troy's got in the first half from individual players. Andrew Evans has 18 points now. Jack Smith with 24. Tommy Davis has got 21. Andy Davis, who seems content with just
kind of piling around out there.
Piling up the assist. Tommy Davis for three. Jack, he's now got 24. Terry McCord has 21. Steve Hunt has three. Tim Faison has six. Chris Gresham has four. Fred Bryant has 17. That's probably a career high for him. Paul Bryant has 14. Brian Simpson has 24.
And one thing that Coach Maestri said on Friday was that he was hoping that everybody would hit a three. Everybody on the team.
And I think it's close. It's now 160 to 71, folks. If you're just tuning in, it's 160 to 71, and there is 14 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the second period.
Wow.
Terry McCord shot that from so far beyond the three-point.
That was a Willie Hicks memorial shot right there. If you'll.
There's a rare three-pointer for Devry. Here's Tommy Davis again. No good. Oh, D'Andrea Evans jumped a little early there. Devry controls the rebound.
You mentioned Andy Davis's contentment to just be out there playing. You know, when we talked to him on Friday, what's the first thing Andy said when you asked about the 200? He said, I don't know, I just want to win the game.
I just want to win, and he's going to get his wish.
Yeah, I think so.
Cortez Daniel continues to be the man as he goes in and lays it in.
Nice move. Andy Davis.
Andy Davis again with the high step. He stops and gives it off to McCord. No good. Rebound. Tommy Davis. And Tommy Davis calling him back. And he hits it. Tommy Davis is hot.
Tommy Davis is waving to Andy. Come on over here and take a three. Andy didn't want anything to do with it, man. He retreated.
Andy Davis with the steal. Jack Smith from way out. That's an air ball. That was from way out. And finally, after about 5 minutes of sitting on the sidelines, here comes the second line, and the Trojans are gonna get a rest. 166 to 76, 21 points away from the record.
I think Simpson's gonna have a new sleeve size after this game's over, after he gets done throwing up the threes he's been taking. Coach Maestri having a word with Andy, saying, Andy, get in the mix, will you? Take a couple shots, buddy. No, Andy, I just like being down there on defense, Coach.
And I think Coach Maestri may be a little bit concerned now about it, about the team trying to show up Devry a little bit much. And I think he told Andy Davis to kind of tone down the showtime just a little bit. Fred Bryant getting the ball over to Paul Bryant. He's got that shot. Nope. He can make the three. And here comes Devry, 2-on-0. Lay-in is good by Clayton Jones. I'd like to see Clayton Jones get some points. He was here last year. No one should have to go through this twice. Tim Faison lays it up. No good. Tapping by Paul Bryant twice. And Devry now, I don't know whether it's what's causing it, but they're seeming to get the ball up the court at least a little bit better now. Their field goal percentage is not improving any. Chris Gresham will stop from three.
They scored 117 points last year, and I think they got a good shot at it if they can get some of those layups they've missed.
Chris Gresham for three. I'd like to see him get it. I hope they break their record. They deserve it.
Nice.
And there's a nice Clayton Jones. Here's Brian Simpson from way out. They're not even coming to the three-point arc anymore. They're just crossing half court and putting it up. And Tim Faison doesn't want anything to do with a two. He stops, pulls it out, turns around, fires it home. 174 to 82.
He got a little disoriented when he saw that paint, and but he spun right out by the Trojan head and ended up out there, and he hit it from there.
Hey, and there's Clayton Jones for three. There's Brian Simpson. He's going to give it up. And Clayton Jones again with a steal.
Fred Bryan is great to watch because every time he's involved in a little bit of a mix-up, he looks over to the bench to see how much razz he's getting from Jack. Here he comes.
Oh! Bryan with the jam. The tip drill paid off right there. It went right through Clayton Jones' hand, and Bryan found himself with a big one.
Nobody rides Fred Bryan higher than Jack than
Andy Davis
and Jack Smith. Jack Smith is his mentor. So whenever Bryan screws up, he looks over to see what Jack's got to say.
Chris Gresham just stopped a solid 7 feet from behind the three-point line and hit nothing but the bottom of the net.
That's his shot.
179-89. That guy wouldn't know what to do with the layup. Here it is again. This time he's in real close, just a foot outside the three-point line. He misses that one.
He threw himself off.
Bryan Simpson goes back out, gets it over to Fred Bryan, and now back into Gresham. Now he gets the chance to prove he can hit a layup, and he did, and it was pretty anticlimactic.
Yes, it was. 181-89.
This crowd's got a lot of nerve, booing.
Look out! That was a nice jam right there by number 40 from Devry.
Sean Kyler.
And he had one earlier. He's
Paul Bryan.
Paul responds.
Paul Bryan, I tell you, in the dunk contest that's gone on here this afternoon, is holding his own with Jack Smith. He's made a couple real pretty dunks.
I'll tell you what, though, if McCord had made that 360, the contest would have been over.
Yeah, that was it. That was a 10. There's Simpson again for three.
Got 1 point away from the old record.
Yep. And I got 1 point away. This is it, folks.
That's going down on the next trip down.
It's going down, and this is it. It's only really now a matter of who is it going to be. And Chris Gresham might put it up from right there. There it is right here for the record. Yes! 189-95. We've got a new NCAA record. 189. And, folks, we've got another quarter of this ball game to play. Tim Faison trying to extend the record, no good. 10 minutes and 9 seconds to play. And that's when the record was set.
And DeVry's got 97, and my guess is they're going to score 130 points in this game.
DeVry will more than likely break their record. And now we've got some Troy State players putting up some hefty scores right now. Tommy Davis has got 27 points, all those via the three-point line. Bryan Simpson has 27 points. He's got a chance to add to that right here as it goes up. No good. Chad Helig with the rebound, and he'll get it out to Clayton Jones.
Simpson stripped him from behind, but a nice play. He got his own rebound and made the layup.
Clayton Jones lays it up and in. They've got 99 points, 189-99. Chris Gresham with the hard jam, 191. Every time Troy State scores, there's a new NCAA record set.
Nice little move there by, is that Kennedy, that 6'9 first?
No, it's D'Artez Daniel.
No, Daniels, I'm sorry.
And now Troy State has attempted so many field goals, and that's definitely a record that's fallen. D'Artez Daniel again with the easy lay-in.
He's racking up a nice little point total for himself, isn't he?
Daniel's got over 20. And here's Bryan Simpson now getting the ball into Fred Bryan, who gives it up. And he gets it in. Paul Bryan sets it up, and now here comes another line for Troy State, and DeVry's got to be wondering when this is going to stop.
Daniel. Reminds me of that Bugs Bunny cartoon when that big giant was going around just scoring all the runs on him. Dun, 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 just scoring all those. Ting, ting, the scoreboard kept changing.
And it's got to look like that now. 193-105. D'Artez Daniel with a nice jam.
Big jam.
He's a good looking ball player.
Hey, he does look good. He moves pretty well out there.
And Coach Maestri now wants a timeout. And he's got it. Coach Maestri does not have a smile on his face. He wants his team to get 200. He wants to see the record. But he's not trying to show up to Fry, and it's got to be mixed emotions for him right now. And now he's giving his team some instructions. And we might see him.
Coach's biggest nightmare is that at some point in his career, he's going to be in the same boat. You know, theoretically, moving up into Division I, a team like ours could run into a juggernaut and come away looking pretty blistered. But
George Strawick has gathered his team around, and they realize what's going on here, and they realize that they're not being humiliated on purpose, really. And they're laughing about it now, and Clayton Jones has got the biggest smile on his face. He was here last year. He's been for this.
Yeah. They got 107 points, so they're 10 points away from their record.
10 points away from their school record, and they'll get that. So all in all, they're not going to go home completely empty-handed from this.
So buddy Vince Hodges from TSU TV, he's probably using up a lot of videotape.
I tell you what, there's going to be a lot of highlights for this one. There's Jack Smith from three, no good. Montez Daniel, he gives
something
it up.
Chad to the
Healy for a two-pointer. No good, Jack Smith.
What happened to Troy State's score? Disappeared.
I don't know, the score.
Andrea
Evans adds two.
Ladies and gentlemen, so many
Evans now has 23.
On the scoreboard, Trojans points will be kept where the fouls are recorded.
And now that's 23 points to Andrea Evans. Terry McCorn has scored again. 8 minutes and 8 seconds to go.
What's that give us now? One.
We're very close to 200. And they're looking for it right now. Here's Steve Hunnell, stop and pop. Yes! That's 200 points. 200 points, exactly. 200 to 105. The impossible, so we thought, has been done with 7 minutes and 43 seconds to go in the game.
Well, it's the combination of the players' number and foul, so it's a multicolored 200.
Steve Hunnell again. 203 to 109. And this is some pretty good scorekeeping now. And we're going to need DeVry here to fix the scoreboard after it's over.
I know.
All
that's
that technical
right.
training is paying off
it's
for them.
It's going to pay off for them.
And DeVry now gets it on 111.
Well, you don't think one of their people sabotaged the scoreboard. Wait a second. Now they got the
now
thing
they're getting it back
cranked
up there.
Up.
And there's Clayton Jones hitting the three.
Clayton Jones
is having a nice game, too. Here's Jack Smith giving it to DeAndre Evans from three. He'll hit that. Now 209 to 111. The buzzer goes off, and there's, Terry McCorn! And we've got a stoppage in play. The buzzer, I think, went off inadvertently.
I'll tell you what, they got more numbers. It looks like a Keno board in Vegas now. I don't know what's going on. They got so many numbers up on the scoreboard.
And now assistant coach David Felix is huddling up with the referees, and they're going to decide what's going to go on here. Let's
not since Mr. Naismith put up the peach baskets long ago have ever so many points been scored in a basketball game.
Okay, now
in
they've
history.
Switched it
you
back over.
Seen history
I kind of like the player foul combination myself.
209 to 113, and the people who are sitting at home right now watching the NFL playoffs are going to be darn sorry they were here at Sartain Hall this afternoon.
That's right. Steve Hunt put us over.
Steve Hunt gave us the 200. And he has got a grin on his face a mile wide. That's probably a record that he's going to be able to tell his grandchildren about. Because 200 points, folks, is a ton of points.
A ton of points. I think Troy State's going to slow it down a little bit now.
Terry McCord from 3-0.
Take the two.
Evans.
Look out. We got to walk,
and
I think.
They're going to call it for double dribbles. And I think you're exactly right, Matt. Troy State has got what they came for.
They're going to tone it down
200
a little bit.
Points.
We're going to have Coach Maestri right after the game, so folks want to make sure they stay tuned and talk to some people about this.
Well, if you want to know what the NCAA record is for most points in a game, you're going to have to stay tuned because we're breaking it with every point. Steve Hunt lays it in, 211 to 115. Dartez Daniel giving the dish off, and it's good. Michael Ramsey with the basket.
By Ramsey.
DeVry just tied their score.
Oh, Jack Smith took it over his head in a hard jam, but it comes out, Dartez Daniel will lay it in, and Dartez Daniel does not even come back past the half point line, the half court anymore. He just stays back and waits for the layups. Oh, Terry McCorn.
Jam by Terry McCorn.
We're seeing some jams that you just can't describe in this ball game.
Andy Davis and Michael Ramsey are getting to be pretty good buddies now. They'll probably swap pictures of their kids down the road and stuff because all they do is when Troy State's down here is stand down there and talk with each other.
Dartez Daniel, they're like hockey goalies.
Yeah.
Dartez Daniel has got 28 points, so he's had a nice trip over to Troy. Terry McCord, the leading scorer for Troy, has got 30.
Another huge jam by Jack Smith.
Jack Smith. Smith has got 26. DeAndre Evans has 26. Tommy Davis has 27. DeAndre Evans, I can't even get the scores out before they go up. They're all going to have over 30. Andy Davis now. Andy Davis must have a ton of assists too. There's Terry McCord. And he lays it in. The Troy State bench is now standing. They've been standing now for every shot.
Michael Ramsey got a dunk there.
Devry really can't even run the floor anymore. They've only got seven players, and they are dead tired. And here's Jack Smith turning around. He'll fire up a three.
Sean Carter was sneaking up behind Jack like he was going to try to block him from behind, but he thought better of that, and he let him shoot it.
It's now 223-125. And Andrew Evans will come up and lay the reverse jam pass. Nice jam. I tell you what. How many points out of the 225 do you think have been jams? Oh, my! And there was a little Showtime attempt right there.
If it hasn't been a three, it's been a jam.
I tell you what, there has been very few. And here comes the second line now. Once again, and Coach Maestri is just switching them out five at a time.
I tell you, if they still had the ban on dunking in college basketball, we'd probably only have about 85 points.
And I tell you what, having the band here to jack up the crowd is one of the most useless things you could possibly imagine at this time. This crowd stood, and they had a little 5-on-5 Little League game going on here at halftime, and the crowd gave them a standing ovation.
I'll tell you what, when DeFry gets back, they're not only going to talk about the score of this game, but they're going to tell people about the national anthem. That's how excited they were.
It's now 232-125, 4 minutes and 13 seconds to go in the second half. Oh, and he hit the floor hard. Oh, my. That's Clayton Jones who hit the floor hard. Check that. That's Sean Kyler.
He's all right.
Ryan Simpson for three, no good. Chris Gresham will come out behind the three-point line. That shot's good.
There's a long bomb.
236-125. Ooh. And it's hard to see anything but pandemonium right now. Chris Gresham will fire up three, no good. Paul Bryan controls the rebound out to Tim Faison. Chris Gresham will look around for somebody to pass to, can't, so he puts it up. Paul Bryan's probably got his career high.
Maestri wants the threes. He wants the threes cut off.
He's asking that they quit shooting the threes. And he's not. It's a mixed bag for Coach Maestri right now. Here's Brian Simpson for three. It's good. 241.
Simpson.
Mac, we went yesterday and we asked how many points this team could score if they were really on. If they played the perfect game, the highest guess we got was 220. They've now scored 241 points.
And of course, we had my phone-in contest also, where we had plenty of entries in that. And the high pick was Steve Barnes from Sports Information. He went with 208, so
a terrible guess.
I'll tell you what, nobody be doing well on the new Price is Right.
No, everybody underbid. 257 to go here in the ball game. And Mac, there have been, I think, if I'm correct, unofficially six fouls called in this game. No one has shot a free throw.
No,
in this ball
there's not
game.
Been a free throw. Now. So this is a record too.
Yes,
of
could
sorts.
Be. It could be.
Now, if you would have missed this, my guess is that there's never been a game played where nobody made a free throw.
That's right.
I took care of that.
And the referees now can all call NutriSystem and cancel their.
That's right.
Cancel their plan. They don't need
they
it
don't
anymore.
Need it
they
anymore.
Dropped 15 pounds in this ball game.
Exactly. They're sucking it up pretty good, though.
Tim Faison goes 2-for-2 from the line. It must be exciting for Tim to take part in this record, right? For I'm sure he's got lots of relatives here.
Friends.
He went to Charles Henderson High School.
Exactly. It's great for him.
And he'll get the three shots. He's fouled on the
Troy
point.
Alabama's Tim Faison makes all three.
And D'Artez Daniel now is just carrying his towel out to midcourt. He probably wants to throw it in right now. But I tell you, probably not, though. He's having a career day for himself.
Michael Ramsey's going to just get a Chase Lounge and put it out by the three mark over there on defense.
I got to tell you, you got to really admire the spirit that DeVry has shown in this game. They haven't gotten frustrated. They've understood what's gone on.
Number 10 from DeVry, Tim Young, may be the only player who has not scored yet.
No, he has scored.
Did he get one?
Yeah, he got some early.
Excellent.
Oh, Brian with a big foul. puts them back up, and they're just going wild. They are going wild. And Devry with the steal.
That's 33. Nice steal and a putback by Michael Ramsey. Here's Steve Hunt. He's going to take it in. Coach Mastry told him, no more threes. Can't get the jam to go.
He wanted the jam.
Fred Bryan.
Fred's got it. Now look out when Fred's out.
He'll get it over. Paul Bryan. He'll put up a three. Good.
Paul Bryan is now 249 to 129. Every basket by Troy State University is a new NCAA record.
Fred Bryan looked over to Coach Mason and said, oh, did I do okay? Was that all right? Coach nodded, said, yeah, that's fine.
Bryan Simpson for three. 253 to 131.
3 points.
Bryan Simpson has 36 points in this ball game. All career highs for almost every Troy State player now. Tim Faison now. He pulls it out, gets it over to Steve Hunt. Back to Bryan Simpson, and he's going to shoot from there. No good. Hunt with the rebound. He'll bring it back out. He'll shoot a three. No good. Simpson with the tip back. No good. Rebound, D'Artes Daniel. He's going to bring it up himself into the forecourt. He'll take it all the way. The lay-in.
He's got that little finger roll.
D'Artes Daniel, 28. Now 30 points for D'Artes Daniel. Here's Fred Bryan with the jam. Yes! And look at the Troy State benches just going wild. Fred Bryan.
Look at Jack Smith.
They won.
That's Fred's his man.
That's fantastic. Fred Bryan finally gets the elusive big jam.
The big jam he's been looking for.
And they're having a blast.
Now, the jam he made at Auburn was very similar to that one, except he took off at about the three-point line. And the ref called one. He was so upset after the game he came, and he said, hey, you were right there on the floor. Did I walk? I walk. And I said, I don't think so. I thought it looked good. And then Jack came over and said, freshman, man.
D'Artes Daniel now with 32.
I'll tell you what.
And there's Devry with the
lane. I'm dying of thirst just talking about it.
Devry has now broke their school record for points in a game by 20 points. We haven't mentioned that. 30 seconds to go in the ball game. It's now 255 to 137. And now there's Bryan Simpson now with the steal, and he'll do the ooh.
Look at
to
this.
Bryan.
Oh, the ball got stuck.
And the referee.
The ball got stuck between the rim and the backboard, and Fred was hanging. Oh, no.
I thought we were going to have to get the physical plant to get Fred down there for just a second.
Well, they got the red tag on the ladder. They can't use it.
17 seconds to play in a complete record-setting afternoon for
Devry. Unbelievable.
We're going to set records that we know of. Now, there's going to be other records that we just don't have any idea about right
That's
now.
A Bryan
Simpson. We've got records for most points by a team in a game. My guess is we've got shattered most points by two teams in a game.
Oh.
So Devry will share that record with Troy State. They've broken their school record. And if
yes.
the game is over, that point will count.
That was an excellent three.
Troy State now has 258 points in a game.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable. And look at the players hugging at halftime. Okay, we've got 258 points of record. 140 points, 141 points combined with the 258. It's going to be most points scored in a ball game combined. 3 points for the 10th in a game. That record fell. 2 points made in a game. That point fell. School records, obviously, all shattered. Career highs for players from Devry and for Troy have probably fell. Mac has gone out onto the court to try to get some words with Coach Mastry. And now, look at the Troy players and the Devry players are having a blast at halftime. There was only one foul in this ball game. There was only three throw shots attempted. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Okay, now here unofficially, we're going to give you some of the scores for Troy State's players. This, believe me, is unofficially. Tony Harris, our statistician, has played the whole game. 30 points for Evans, 29 points for Smith, Tommy Davis with 27, Terry McCord with 32, Steve Hunt with 11, Tim Faison with 12, Chris Gresham has 20, Fred Bryan 27, Paul Bryan with 25, and Bryan Simpson with 39 points in the ball game. Those are complete unofficial scores. And Mac is going to try to get a word now with a couple of the players. For Devry, Now, unofficially, Young had 6 points. Chad Helig with a nice game. He had 23. D'Artez Daniel played an outstanding ball game, a good-looking ball player. He had 35 points. Jones with 11. Michael Ramsey had 10. Sean Kyler, 21. And Eugene Quarles had 5 points on the ball game. And now, Mac, if you can get a word now with the Troy State players. They're now
number one in Detroit. Can't beat us.
Jack, let's talk to Jack Smith for a minute. Well, Jack, 258, somebody said at practice Friday, 210. You guys went way over that.
Yes, sir, we did. You know, we shot the ball well tonight. You know, we ran up and down the floor. And we practiced threes. You know, we practiced 50 threes and a half, you know, in 10 minutes. Well, we actually shot.
Made 82 of them or something in about
yes.
Five.
Yes.
Do is dunk, you know, so we try to get him to stay down the floor so he could, you know, show everybody he could dunk.
How are you guys going to get back on track now for the next game? You're going to have some tougher opponents down the road. You got to kind of shake this stuff off and get back into it.
Well, we're enjoying this win right now, you know. When we come out for practice, you know, tomorrow, if not tomorrow, the next day, we'll try to put this behind us and, you know, just come out here and start practicing like we normally do and, you know, prepare for the next game.
How about the fellas from Devry? Were you talking to them out there? Were they having a good time?
Yes, they was. You know, they a bunch of good guys. You know, they got a lot of good spirit. They wanted to play. They wanted, you know, stay out here. And they wanted us to get the record, you know, so we got it. And they, you know, they're sharing a part of the glory.
Great. Excellent. Thanks a lot. Good
thanks.
Luck.
All right.
Jeremy McCord, 38.
Hey,
Chris Fresham,
20. Hey, how's it going? You picked 210. You missed by 48 points.
Yeah. It just feel good to get 200, man.
You guys started out a little tight.
Yeah, we did. We did. We was kind of uptight trying to score. You know, we were a little nervous, but once we calmed down, we got in that rhythm, got in that stroke, and we shot the ball pretty well.
And you're shuttling players in and out of there. I suppose it's not a matter of people getting tired out. You guys were all fresh when you went in.
Yeah. Yeah, our freshmen played good. And Coach was put in a position where they could play good and shine, and hopefully get in a rhythm, get more used to college basketball. Overall, I think our freshmen played good.
What was Coach Maestri saying to you guys once you got over 200? Was he looking for you guys to maybe slow it down a little bit?
Well, once we got 200, he was going for the three-point attempt record. So after we got 200, basically we were trying to get three-point attempt record, a three-point made record also.
And now you got to shake this off and get ready for the next game, which will probably be a little tougher opponent. You guys are still working hard to get a tournament bid.
Yeah, from this point on, we basically got to win the rest of our games to make the tournament. So this is our fun right here. Now it's back to getting
now
serious
back
again.
Yeah. All right, good luck. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Oh, Mac, I tell you, there's so many records being broken in this game. People are going to have to go home, and they're going to have to wait until they compile up all the stats.
Shots taken, shots made, threes taken.
All of them broken, shattered, really. Broken is not even a strong enough word.
Six fouls
in the ball game. So.
And Tri-State, well, minimum number of turnovers. And I mean, I think you said they had like three in the first half.
Three turnovers in the first half. That everything we have is unofficial. When you get the game going at that pace, there's just no way that you can possibly keep the stats going. Tom Enzi's going to have to pile that up. In fact, the final score's already been changed. It's listed now. It's I think Troy actually had an extra point at 259.
259.
I think
it was
140
was on the board.
Was the final. But
let's see if we can get a couple other people in here. Come out here, Terry. What's going on?
Not much, man. We're just glad this 200-point thing over with.
Yeah, so you don't have to worry about that. We're back to work now, huh?
Oh yeah, we gonna practice hard again. We practice harder than what we practiced for Bellarmine for this game.
Really?
Believe it or not, yeah. We practiced 3-pointer for like 10 minutes straight. Shot about 129. I think we hit 129 three-pointers in about 10 minutes.
What did Coach Maestri say to you at halftime when you guys realized you had a shot at breaking this thing, even shattering it?
He just wanted us to go out here and hit the first three. You know, he said we hit the first three so we wouldn't be cold the first few minutes before we had to sweat it out in the last, like, few minutes. And we was lucky to have some great players to hit the first three.
First 10 minutes, you weren't on the pace. You guys came out, you were a little bit tight, but then there was about a 3-minute burst there where it seemed like you scored about 25.
Yeah.
I know Jack Smith and Brian Simpson both got real hot, and the threes just started going, and then it was like contagious.
Yep. I think we were sort of nervous about that 200-point thing, and everybody wanted to hit that first three to get it going. Jack hit the first one, I think.
Yeah.
And then that's just, I guess that eased attention, and so
starting
we started on from there.
Excellent. Who do you guys got next now?
I think Alabama Huntsville. Who knows? Repeat.
Anything's repeat. Possible
yeah,
now, huh?
Anything's possible.
So. Excellent. Well, congratulations and good luck for the rest of the season.
Thanks.
Come on in, Brian. This guy had the hot hand for a while there.
To say the least. 38 points, is that right, unofficially?
I think that's what they said. I'm really not sure yet.
Yeah, everything is unofficial, but you like that three-point shot, don't you?
Oh, yeah, a lot.
You hit about, we mentioned that first 10 minutes, as far as a 200-point pace, you were a little bit behind, but then you and Jack really got hot.
Yeah, I think, well, we had a lot of open threes, so, you know, it's just a matter of fact knocking them down. I mean, just we kept putting them up, so everybody seemed to get hot. And once somebody else got hot, it seemed like the whole team just started getting hot. D got real hot, Tommy got real hot. Tommy really got hot in the second half. I thought he hit about four in a row, I think, before even missing. So, I mean, the whole team really got hot.
I asked you the other day, if this team played as good a game as they could possibly play, how many points they could score? And you said 220.
20, yeah.
And now you've got
250.
Did you in your wildest imagination think?
No way I ever thought we could ever score over 250.
When you go back to Kentucky, people aren't going to play.
Oh, when I go back to Kentucky, people are going to be going crazy. they might all come down on a bus just to see us play one time.
I think you may have set a record also for most 3 points attempted in a game. I'm not sure that's completely unofficial, but I bet you were close.
I think, was it Calvin Auburn? He held that record.
I think
the guy, they were kind of yelling for me to shoot because they think I needed one more or two more to break the record. They kept trying to get me there to ball towards the end of the game. I'm not sure if I broke the record or not.
In the game against Devry last year, Calvin had a stretch where I think Coach Maestri said he scored 27 points in about four and a half or five minutes.
Coach told me about that earlier. He said he hit like seven in a row.
Seven in a row and like 8 out of 10.
You talked to some of the DeVry players after the game. What was their spirit like?
They were as happy as we were because they were a part of it. I mean, they were over here hugging us and telling us a good game and everything.
Shattered the record for two teams most score in a game. Yeah. So they're part of that, and they'll share that record with y'all.
I think they went over their old mark by about 20 points.
Yeah, they broke their school record for most points, which they set last year in this game
really?
Also.
Okay.
How does this, I talked to a couple of the other players now, how does this fare as far as the rest of the season goes? I mean, you guys got to kind of shake this off and get back to work now because getting that at-large bid is not going to be easy. You guys are going to play tough the rest of the year.
That's what a coach has been telling us all year. You know, that's our main goal, to get into the tournament. And we got to just basically go undefeated, I guess. And hopefully this publicity for scoring over 200 points will help us out a lot. And
I have a feeling you'll make a few papers tomorrow.
I'll tell you what, there are a lot of basketball fans who would be happy to see Troy State get to the Final Four of a tournament because of this brand of basketball. I mean, everybody was so charged up here that when they brought the little kids out to play at halftime, that kid hit a layup, the place went about once the roof went off, and they were so pumped up.
Yeah, that's really what we want to do, is our main goal to get to the tournament. And we know that's really going to be hard to accomplish without, you know, winning the rest of our games, having a good year.
How many wins do you think you'll have to get to that tournament?
Well, Coach is talking about having undefeated the rest of the year and get, you know, what would that be, make us 24-3. And, I think it's possible for us. We just got to play the way we've been playing. So, that's our main goal, to get the tournament.
Here comes a couple fellows who chipped in with the hot hand.
Tommy, you got hot in the second half and came out smoking and kind of
everybody caught the bug after that.
Yeah, you watched Brian Simpson shoot and a couple other guys hit. You know, he's like, damn, you got to get in the act too. So,
yeah. You got in the act all right.
We talked to you on Friday. You said, 220? 220 maybe?
Oh, you know, I just exaggerated a little bit. I know we probably get over. Come on in here.
We was born together, raised together.
And I'm the illegitimate son.
Yeah. Here's the guy who hit the 3 that sent it over the 200.
That's right,
to give you a ball or something.
Nah.
I was
telling him to get me the ball.
Yeah, he was
on the one who scores the last time.
Give him a towel knock, but he was mad because we weren't getting the ball. I told him I wasn't going to get in the ball.
Hey, I'm not a jumper. I just tried. Yeah, I need to get outside out in the three-point land.
All right.
We told him we couldn't jump over a piece of paper. He said he was going to prove it wrong.
I can't. I'll get up there one time this year.
What about Fred? Fred finally got that big jam he was looking for. You know, he's still talking about that one they took away from him in Auburn.
And then he broke the ice.
And then he missed five the other night. So we were happy that he got that one.
He got a couple in. He got a couple in.
He try to get him.
He got lodged up in the rim there. He's a freshman. You got to give him a hard time.
Yeah, freshman, you know.
We had to initiate him. Beat him up in the hotel.
But he's doing really good because, you know, freshmen don't hardly come
he's
in and play too much.
Oh, he's a very athletic.
Like he's got dunkaholic. Every time he touches, he wants to dunk.
We're trying to learn it's more than a basketball game than a dunk, you know.
Well, we were watching him over on the bench, and after about 4 minutes was going, he was drooling. They had to give him a big towel because he couldn't wait to get out on the floor and start jamming the ball.
But, you know, you got to give it to him, a freshman coming in to play good as he's playing. So we're really proud that he can come
in. Hey, I want to know something. Does Jack have some kind of a voodoo hex over him? Because every time Fred does something wrong out on the court, he looks over at Jack Smith to look like he's going to get in trouble from Jack.
Yeah, because Jack one of the best dunkers, so he's just trying to ask him what he's done wrong. What's my feet far apart?
I'd hate to have to judge a dunking contest from the highlights on this thing. You guys had some monster
chances. I think I win the dunk contest on the game tonight.
We'll give it to you.
Heavy style points.
We'll give him a 9 3/4.
Just because I jumped.
Good luck for the rest of the season, guys.
All right, thanks, guys. Congratulations.
A terrific record.
Excellent. Take it easy, Terry.
Well, Mac, it's been a hectic afternoon for us, to say the least. And, you know, it was tough to call all this. And I hope people understand what they've seen here today.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm not sure I understand what I saw here today, but it sure was a lot of fun. And I know... Now that this is behind them, they'll just focus on, like they said, getting to the tournament.
That's right, and it should be a big game coming up again, and we'll see how they come down from this, because it'll definitely be a drop-off, that's for sure.
Nice working with you again. We're about to get out of here. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot.
And we'll say goodnight to everybody.
Take care.